Hello and welcome to Delirious Gaming episode 24. It's the 28th of June 2012 and the game in the background is still Magic the Gathering Duels of the Planeswalkers 2013. Now, the game I've been playing last night was LEGO Batman 2 and I must say it's really quite a LEGO game again. Now, on to the main gaming news. Pokemon Black and White 2 will appear on October 12th. It's already available in Japan and has sold more than 1.5 million copies. And it's the first game this year that managed to sell more than 1 million copies in Japan, so who knows what it will do. Ubisoft is making a game based on The Expendables 2. The game will be available on Xbox Live Arcade, PlayStation Network and PC. And you can play the game offline or online with a total of 4 players. And that's about it. The Nintendo 3DS XL will get its own Circle Pad expansion. A lot of people expected the bigger Nintendo, the new design, to have a second analog stick, seeing as it was the biggest point of complaints of the original Nintendo. But they didn't add it, so they're making a new extensions so you can still use your second stick. Black Ops 2 will get a new version of the Nuketown map. A very popular map of the original Black Ops was Nuketown. At least that's what is said at the moment. So they're trying to remake it into the second one, and who knows. Earlier this week I mentioned that Valve and Adult Swim were doing something together, but they didn't say what. At the moment, they have announced that they made a hat for Team Fortress 2, which is a robot chicken hat, usable in Team Fortress 2, and you can get it by signing up for the newsletter of Adult Swim. They might do something more in the future, but they haven't released it yet. And Atari is celebrating its 40th birthday with free iOS games. All the classic arcade games in the Atari's Greatest Hits app are temporarily free to download. The Last of Us will get no co-op campaign mode. As has been said by the creative director Neil Druckmann, I don't know, and game director Bruce Twaley. They were asked how they would do it, seeing as Uncharted games had a really big success with their online cooperative playing mode, but they haven't thought anything about it. A Broken Sword will be available on Android. The developer Revolution Software has announced it. They also announced that they are working on a new adventure game for the past 6 months, and details of the game will be announced shortly. And for those of you who are in Europe, and especially near the Netherlands, First Look 2012 will be held on 6 and 7 October this year, and it will be held in Utrecht in and they have some new They have some major points. They have Nintendo's new console, the Wii U, with the titles Nintendo Land, Super Mario Bros., which are playable. We're expecting Call of Duty Black Ops 2, Assassin's Creed 3, FIFA 2013, Halo 4, Company of Heroes 2, Dishonored, Resident Evil 6, The Last of Us, and Halo, and many, many more. You can get tickets for €10, or you can get a VIP ticket for 20, which gives you 2 hours of earlier access, and you get preference at the theater. And there is a patch for the PC version of Ghost Recon Future Soldier. The patch is made to increase the stability and balance of the online multiplayer. It also increased the voice chat quality for the Vista users, and they made navigating through the menus a bit better. The beta of Source Filmmaker, which is a tool which users can use to make movies of games who use the Source engine, has been made available as of today. At the moment, Valve has announced a bit about it. If you want to see what the Source Filmmaker can do, you got to look at the Team Fortress 2 Meet the Pyro movie. They made it with their new tool. And Phosphor Games has announced Horn for the iOS. And the big news of today. Guild Wars 2 has announced its release date. It will get the last beta in the weekend of 20 till 22 July. And after that, it will be set to release on August 28. If you pre-order, you can get a 3-day head start. But it's pretty awesome that they finally announced a new date. Now, on to the release dates. We have 2 games in Europe for tomorrow, which is Mystery PI for the Nintendo DS and Special Ops The Line for the PlayStation 3, Xbox 360 and the PC. We also have some games in the US. The Walking Dead Episode 2 Starved for Help is released. Other than that, we have U-Shift for the iPhone and Mini Ninjas Adventures. Now, before we go to the last part of the show, the Kickstarter, I have something extra today. Seeing as there is a new Indie Gala. The Indie Gala features a few games, mostly Commandos. So you have Commandos Behind the Enemy Line, Commandos Beyond Call of Duty. And if you pay more than the average, which at the moment is $6.24, you get Commandos 2 Men of Courage and Commandos 3 Destination Berlin. But you also get, with the basic packets, the game The Void. And with the bonus packets, Iron Assault, Air Conflict Secret Wars, and Cargo, The Quest for Gravity. All these games are available for Steam. As far as I know, they are also all available as DRM-free downloads. The bundle has been sold about 6,500 times, and has 12 days left at the moment. In the second week, they will also announce a few secret bonuses, but of course, more of that next week. So, for the Kickstarter, I have Cult Awakening of the Old Ones, It has 7 days left to go. It needed $5,000. And it already got $21,000. They made a few stretch goals. Which are quite nice to see. Cult is an open-ended role-playing game set in a user-generated world with a strong focus on storytelling. So, looks interesting. It doesn't have high graphics, of course. But I'm quite curious how it will turn out. It looks like something of a real old game. But seeing as how retro games are at the moment the hardest thing to have, it might just be a good thing to have. So if you have any questions, you can send them to youtube@healthwife.com. I'll post some links on the blog. If you're watching on YouTube, you can find the description to the blog, the link to the blog in my description. And I'll see you guys tomorrow.